Hello everybody. They call me Muse, and I am extremely confused as to what's just occurred. Was it your doing? Wretched, misbegotten, awful creature. I assume it wasn't, but I'm going to blame you regardless. Yeah, you've got nothing new to add. You freak. So yeah, here we are, back in the Warlock's Wilds, where we have a torch because it's bloody dark. And we have a door, which we can actually open. Now, we didn't lose our memory when we died just now, so that's promising. Is this the spot where we were when we just died? Might have been. It's been a day or two. Let's have a poke around, shall we? So we've got another door. Takes us out to what looks to be a new area. I don't remember running up this slope before. We have a pool of some sort. Oh, it's something good, therefore try and keep going. Is it something good? Ah, it's Blade the Bald's withered icon. Excellent. So we should definitely pop back to old Blade in the quest vault. Hand that over to him. And now what? Now we're back in Orshaft Village all of a sudden. Curious. And we've got a gate. Ah, that's the gate that leads us back to our anvil. Very good. So it shouldn't be too hard to get back to Blade the Bold from here, I wouldn't think, because if we can go into the depths and then up, and then we're fairly close to where we'd need to be. Let's just have a quick look, shall we, through our compendium. So, lots of stuff has already been restored, that's good. Festivity Row, though. From centre stage. I forgot to even have a look at this dancing pole that we picked up. But we may have to at some point. And then we've got all of the disgrace set now, so we could get that restored. Nothing else in the quest reward vault. And then we've got a few things in the Warlock's Wild, but we've not finished exploring there anyway, so all is well. And some undiscovered regions. Very good. There is, however, another relic which I picked up on my other character, because there's some mutually exclusive achievements. We can't get them all in one playthrough, so I am playing more than one. On my Dex build, oops, I found a shield in the vaults that we'd previously missed. So let's go and collect that. Shouldn't be too hard now. Ah, the struggles we had in here in the past. No longer an issue. Probably a good place to get practice with rebuff. But I'm still not entirely down with it, so we'll see. There we go, we got one just like that. Excellent stuff. So yeah, if we came up here and went towards the elite dude. Then there is a shield. How have you not seen us yet? There we go, we got you in the end. Now we're going to get donkeyed. Oops. Once again we failed the rebuff. We failed it too early and got hit. That guy just didn't even hit us at all. How odd. So yeah, we'll sneak up this way again. Let's see. Donkeys. Excellent, we pulled it off that time. And yeah, there it is. The shelter shield. So it's memory lingers in the path of the good monarch. Have we even been there? Why is it showing up as a non-undiscovered area? I don't think we've been there. Pixelating carapace from a road-crossing beast. Full spectrum of magic was used to add colour to the hero's journey. And that feeling is lost from our world. What does it mean? Who can say? But now that that's out of the way, we'll head back to the start of the depths and we'll go up and make our way back to the quest reward vault. Because I want to free Blade before we come across anything where we might need his help, like a boss fight or similar. It's possible there's a quicker way to get back to our friend than going up here, but I don't know. I think the narrator's past screwing with us at this point, so no more trains to worry about. Oh, this just takes us to Festivity Road, doesn't it? So we've got to go further on still to get to the quest reward vault. But we do have the Golden Shower and the centre stage, so we've got a couple of things to do in Festivity Row anyway. Now, we were going to go for Six Source, weren't we? To be able to heal over time. But I'd also like to go for Five Luck, just because that's going to unlock a luck ability. Now, we could return Blade's icon as well, but we're not going to do that because we want to finish his quest. And we can't do that unless we actually start it. But yeah, we've now unlocked critical hits. We've got a 3% chance of doing them, so it's not great. But that's still a damage increase. So it's still probably worthwhile. Now, the golden showers rained down from above was one of our clues. Which makes me think we're headed up towards where... Oh, you grabbers again. Just stop it. There we go. At least we can one-shot the bugger. So yeah, do we go all the way down and then take the elevator up to find these? Because that's where the golden toilet was. So perhaps that's also where the showers are. It said rain down from above on the clue. The showers from the golden guards above. Yeah, maybe that means we need to be down below them. Because above is where the golden guards might be. Although, let's think. So it's definitely in Festivity Row, right? So it could be somewhere down low, after all. Because it could refer to where the showers come from, up above. Or it could refer to a low down place where the showers rain down onto. Because this would be where the golden guards lived, I guess, with their golden toilet. In their golden beds and wardrobes and whatnot. In their Sonic the Hedgehog shrine. But then were their beds further down below? Yeah, there's ordinary looking beds on the levels below. So maybe that's where the disgraced guards lived. So Maybe we do have to explore on these lower levels. Oh, we got a crit. Lovely. Game staggered slightly when we did, but hey-ho. And it's not like we need to crit these guys, because we can pretty much one-shot them, but still. So, maybe that. It's a pipe of some sort. No. Is this below where the golden toilet was? And it just splats onto the floor. Yeah, I'm somewhat at a loss on this one. What else do we have? Oh yeah, Nom's dancing pole. Center stage. So yeah, I guess we'll work our way back down. Ah, here we go. Found it on the ground floor. So it was right down the bottom. I think I was on the right track with it being underneath the toilet. So, we've got the full disgrace set now. Carries a disturbing odour. Nostalgaia had always been hierarchical. Heroes of the Pinnacle. NPCs are subservient. Mercutio altered the process of rebirthing. And NPCs began building hierarchies of their own. The disgrace turned on their own kind in pursuit of power. My wearer made the mining donkeys squeal beneath my heel. The pipe layer and the consumer were kind of working together on extracting stuff from the mines, but they couldn't agree on what they should be extracting. So these disgrace guys who run the mines would always disappoint either one or the other. Very well. But now we can take the elevator back up and head to the stage and find out about Nom's dancing pole. Yeah, those guys who had been throwing rocks at us or knives at us from up above haven't respawned, it seems. Also, it looks like we're underneath a banana tree. We are underneath a banana tree. That is almost certainly a point of interest for later on. And that golden guard who stood up there hasn't respawned either. Curious. Now, how many of them are going to follow us down here to center stage? So this little nubbin here, I guess, would be where Nom's dancing pole used to sit when he did pole dancing, presumably. Oh. Bugger off. I'm about to die. There we go. So yeah, running down here didn't get anyone to tether away from us, it seems. And now they're all taking it in turns to munch on our head. Well, that's fine. We can... Oh, we can't use a healing item because every time we try, we get knocked out of the animation by our knife-throwing pal. Yeah, this was a bad idea, just roaming around down here like this. But that's fine. We're getting there. We've recovered. But you were causing so much aggro, it's ridiculous. Right. Everyone's dead. That guy's left behind a glittery thing. But the main thing is, everyone's dead. Now, Nom's dancing pole. So halberd, strength and source. When Wielder spawned in the company of amnesiac and a thief. His party members were greeted with deference, honour and gratitude. Earthy and Hitch, perfect manifestations of heroism. My little hero has patted on his head and asked to dance for giggles. The tree had heard rumours of a mysterious pipe layer who had usurped control of the gauntlet. They brandished me and the other weapons to save the day. So everyone gave credit to Earthy and Hitch, and no one gave any credit to Nom. And then Nom was propositioned by a mustachioed stranger. The trio seemed to have the upper hand in the fight against the pipe layer. So he was basically a bard of some sort, but he was using inspiring dance moves to buff his allies. And then he stabbed them in the back, took everything that had been previously denied to him. When he danced upon me from center stage, his audience quickly learned not to laugh. Fair enough. So the pipe layer came first, Nom came later, and betrayed his chums. But now we can head on to find Blade, which was originally my plan about 20 minutes ago. It's a little touch, but I love the way elevators just snap into existence. When you return, you don't have to wait for them to come all the way down to your floor. So we're back in the vault. And what's the compendium have to tell us about the vault? We've got everything remembered. Very well. So those guys are going to do their thing. Stab up that lad while we just make our way through to the beacon, I think. Oh wait, was there even a beacon in here? Or is it down in the consumer's kitchen? Yeah, it's down in the consumer's kitchen. We may well have just splurged all of our healing items earlier than necessary, but that's fine. Let's use a green herb. That will get us a bit of health back at least while I have a sip of my coffee. Jeez, they smashed him. I wasn't expecting them to smash him quite so quickly and easily. So now we've got a lot of dudes on our attack. Ah. And they... Yep. They don't quite go down in a hit, which is unfortunate. But if we do hit and run like that... Nice. Yeah, running strikes are very good because they don't seem to have much wind-up. Now, why do you even have a heroic icon, Blade? Were you a boss at some point?
Did you find old Blade's icon? I'll be a little worse for wear, but... Thanks, kid. Bold, they called me. Though I never earned the title. Back in my cycle, there was still hope that a champion would spawn. Someone to counter the evils of our kind. I had the conviction, all right. Don't you doubt it. Just lacked the courage to carry it. So I never faced the pipe layer. Broke the oath implicit in what we are.
Guess that's why you're no longer a hero of any sort.
I had ambitions back in the day. Save a princess, become a venerable archetype, all that starry-eyed nonsense. The cycles wear on you, kid. They wear on you. Used to be a lot of heroes in these cells. When the chasm emerged, well, it offered a better solution for those who wouldn't cower. Guess that's why I was never taken. My icon had already withered with my bravery. To think, all this time, I could have just died.
The chasm? Is that where all that black pixelate stuff is coming from?
Don't make the same mistake I did, kid. You be the hero old Blade couldn't be. I know you can. Don't make the same... You be the... I know you...
Very well. We will do our best to be the hero. Either way, you can go about your business now, my friend. There's nothing keeping you in that cage any longer. Maybe one day he can be the hero again. Why is that drawing the attention of Halberd guy? Oh, don't die now. Das, right by the beacon. Right, so where's our tether actually set at the moment? Oh, good. I was worried I'd moved it onto Warlock's Wilds, but it seems not. Therefore, getting back our memory shouldn't be too much of a challenge. And there we go. Lots of delicious memory for us. Now, NPC City connects back to here. Festivity Row apparently connects back to here. How have we not found the door in Festivity Row that leads back here yet? Unless it's all blocked off and broken, which is why it looks to be buried on the other side. Maybe these aren't real doors. Maybe they aren't shortcut doors because they're all blocked up by goop. Could be that all those areas used to connect to here, but no more. But anyway, let's start work on getting to 6 source. It's only 2 levels away now. We can afford that. What level are we now? Level 43. I've learned that the level cap is 99. But we've got a long way to go yet. And actually, while we're at it, what's our insight bonus? So we've got increased stamina, regen speed. We need 5 more to increase damage for remembered weapons again. Aha! This was the path of the good monarch, was it? So, let's see. That's where the shield was remembered, wasn't it? It was something about colours. The full spectrum of magic was used to add colour to the hero's journey. Is that going to refer to the Bridge of Hope? But yeah, if this isn't the full spectrum of magic that's being referred to, then I'll be very surprised. There we go. It's not a great shield from the look of its stats, but let's see how it changes. And it's still not a great shield. It's a blue shell, of course. The narrator was the most exuberant cheerleader in all of Nostalgaia. His belief in the institution of heroism was unwavering. To conduct the hero's journey and articulate its wonder, the narrator wielded his immense power over source. Nobody thought much about source back then, where it came from or what it was. Magic was simply accepted as part of the code of existence. After the degradation began, some who were never meant to access source began harnessing it through unconventional means. At first, the narrator tried to believe that this too was part of a greater plan. This forbidden use source was called glitch. Carapace from a road crossing beast that could knock a carriage off its course. Yeah, blue shells will do that. And we're on Rainbow Road, as I've previously mentioned. So yeah, that all seems to fit together quite nicely as a Mario Kart reference. Now we're back in the wilds where 5 of our relics can be remembered. So yeah, I think we just completely missed this door the first time we came into the wilds. But now that we've found it, we've unlocked some more shortcuts that I'm inevitably going to forget about or forget how to use. But either way, this is probably a good place to tether our beacon to now. And it's probably a good place to end the episode as well. So, yeah. Next time we'll proceed through the Warlock Wilds again. And hopefully we won't just die and respawn back here for no clear reason. Thanks for watching, friends.